Welcome to 5 Minutes Ago, a show we wrote, well, 5 minutes ago.
To infinity and beyond!
With our hosts, Molly Plunkett, Alec Karagosian, Jess Gurung, and Asa Rosemeyer.
With this week's guest host, Tomas Estrada Donahue.
Fasten your seatbelts.
Welcome to 5 Minutes Ago.
And a special welcome to our guest host this week, Tomas Estrada Donahue.
Happy to be here. It's much more exciting than all the other things I'm doing right now.
Tomas, what else are you doing right now?
I'm actually on the superintendent search committee, and we're looking for a new superintendent who can manage the budget, deal with the Belmont, with all of the Belmont schools, deal with our financial predicaments, and a new school configuration. Students, don't forget to take the survey to share your thoughts on what our next superintendent will need to succeed. The link is in the description below.
I'll fill that survey out right after this week's announcements.
Congratulations to our Marauders of the Week, Ailinn Capitani and Olympia Kazantzidis. We also would like to take a moment to thank all of the staff members who have helped with the Marauder of the Week over the years, most especially Mr. Maresco and Ms. Carla Boddy.
Now that we're in the season of snow falling and ice buildup, the safest walkway for students is under the overhang. We encourage students to not walk where snow and ice can fall from the rooftop. It is also very important that no one walks on the frozen pond or any other frozen body of water. Although some spots may look strong, it definitely isn't.
Belmont High School will once again be offering students the opportunity to advance a year in math for the 2023-2024 school year, if that student has taken an equivalent course at another institution. This opportunity is for students entering grades 9 through 12 in September 2023. Please check the description for more information.
Auditions for the 2023-2024 Belmont High School Wind Ensemble, Chamber Orchestra, and Chamber Singers will be taking place the week of March 6th through March 10th, 2023. Please email Ms. Lacasse for band, Mrs. Reevy for orchestra, or Ms. Donovan for chorus with questions if you have them. Students are also welcome to email the directors if they are interested in joining the non-audition performance ensembles, symphonic band, concert, orchestra, or the chorale. Link to folder with audition details and teacher emails are in the description.
Wednesday's snack mix bar for students was a huge success. Many thanks to the volunteers who helped serve the snack mix and to everyone who donated supplies. This event was part of the PTSO's Acts of Kindness for Students initiative. To learn more, visit the PTSO website and their Instagram.
9th, 10th, and 11th graders, course selection season is upon us. If we could give you one piece of advice, it would be to pick classes that give you time to do the after-school activities you love to do and to spend time with the people you love.
This year's Spain trip is doing a Valentine's Day fundraiser the week before break. They'll be selling Hershey's Kisses and lollipop-grams to be delivered on Valentine's Day. The sale will take place in the foyer on Monday and Tuesday mornings and on the second floor balcony those afternoons. And now for our sports announcements.
The Belmont boys indoor track team is stacked this year. They had four athletes qualify for states. Those are seniors Jason Wu, 55 meters, Lukas Sendzik in the 1K, Ronnie Rubinshtein in the 2 mile, and junior Austin Lasseter in both the high jump and long jump. Wishing them the best of luck in their league meet today. On the girls' side, despite having a smaller roster than most of their competition, senior captains Alina Maier and Miriam Woods have helped the team stay motivated and go above and beyond during meets. Also, a shout out to sophomore Ailinn Capitani's amazing performances in the 1,000 meter this season. So far, she's finished top 10 in all but one meet, with a superb second place finish in the Middlesex League Liberty Block. Great stuff, BHS Track. Make sure to check the description for this week's sports schedule. And now for our arts announcements.
On Thursday, February 9th at 7 p.m., the Modern Band class will be playing their first concert. Located in the Black Box, the Modern Band will feature 30 performers who will play songs by The Police, Bob Dylan, Red Hot Chili Peppers, and Billy Joel. Free to anyone to come and listen.
10 students from Belmont High School have been selected to participate in the MMEA All-State Music Festival this year, which will take place on March 2nd to March 4th in Westford, Mass. The All-State concert on March 4th will be held at Symphony Hall in Boston. See the description for a list of students who qualify.
Congratulations to all the Scholastic Art Award recipients. Belmont once again dominated the competition. All of our gold winners will move on to the national competition in New York. Use a QR code to see the full list of winners, including silver medalists and honorable mentions.
Special recognition goes to Joy Sun and Joshua Way, who won first and third place in the UMass Dartmouth Emerging Young Artist Competition. This is the eighth out of the 10 years of the competition our students came in first. Congrats to all of our BHS artists on their amazing work. In addition to using the QR code, you can see the description for the list of all Scholastic Art Award winners.
And now for this week's We Ask You.
Who has made your day or week or month?
All my teachers, after giving me back my midterms, it really made my week so fun.
So you did well?
No.
Probably my chemistry teacher, because he gave me a +5 curve, so I got a 91 on my midterm.
Who is your chemistry teacher?
Dr. Molk.
Sage has made me happy. She's been really so funny, made lots of funny jokes.
Sage, tell us a joke.
What did one strawberry say to the other?
I don't know.
If you weren't so fresh, we wouldn't be in this jam.
I'd say my grandma made me happy yesterday.
Tomas, because he got a good grade on his midterm.
Which midterm?
None.
Okay, Tomas, who's made you happy?
Follow me.
Oh. Damien has made me happy.
Mr. O made me happy because he gave us Hershey kisses.
I like to say my girlfriend. She takes me to get food. I'm fat.
I'll say my friends.
Jonathan, Ava, she's right there. And then Tabby.
Maribel and Gabrielle, I eat lunch with them every day.
I'd say Miss Weathers, my dog Creed, my other dog Chanel, my other dog Hennessy, my other dog. I have a lot of dogs. I have 5.
Let's go.
Why?
His energy is just, he's vibrant.
You, Molly.
Satchel Kenkray in the blue Manchester City jersey with the...
Andy.
My mom.
Andy. He's got a nice smile.
You for giving me this chance to be on 5 minutes ago.
Regina George.
Regina George or Sachi Capitani? Hard to tell who's who.
Taylor Swift. Now we got bad blood. You know we used to be mad blood.
My good friend and icon of the freshman class, Lucas Kolb.
Come on, Bryce, just stand here. Come on.
Bryce Hubbard.
Yeah, he makes me happy too.
Neymar. I love Neymar.
People who give me food.
My daughter, my son, and my nieces, we had a fun play session, and we bought this thing of cookies that allows you to find out your unicorn name. My unicorn name would be Neon Starlight.
Speech and Debate Club. It's amazing. It's a great community.
Lily Phillips.
Milo, for sure.
Mr. Bruno.
This is the first time we've seen a guest host appear on the We Ask You. Tomas, we would like an update though. What's made you happy this weekend?
Little Freddy, the cook at Moosey's, made me happy by cooking up in the kitchen for me.
Post-practice Moosey trips are a classic. I hope Little Freddy will cook up for me too. On another food note, last week we asked you if you prefer salsa or guacamole, and we got some great responses. Here are the top three.
At number three, I'm not paying $5 extra for guac at Chipotle. Salsa, easily.
At number two, this sentence, I'm eating guacamole, sounds more sophisticated than I'm eating salsa.
And at number one, we have, if I'm making guac, then I can pelt the pits at any unsuspecting passerby.
And the winner by a landslide was guacamole with 82.6%.
This week we want to know, Kids Bop, Glee cast or original version? What do you think, Tomas?
Original version. Not a big fan of Kids Bop and never heard of Glee cast before.
Well, I'm a Glee cast girl through and through. Any Amy Winehouse song performed in Glee cast has my heart. Anyways, thanks for being here, Tomas.
I've had a great time.
See you all next
time.
Bye.
Make sure to follow us on Instagram at 5minutesago_BHS. Also, hit the QR code on the screen to find the question of the week.
Nobody just yet, but I can make your day. Watch me dance.
I'm okay. Editing this week, so I'm going to keep that in.
Okay, great. Asa, we would like to hear you, but we cannot.
You hear me?
But we can't see you. We can't see you. You are a charcoal gray square.
This is not ideal.
He's throwing the pit, the avocado pit at someone. Yeah, I mean, I guess it's technically violent. But it's
kind
avocado.
Of violent, guys.
I'm not gonna lie. Those are like...
Jess, do you have siblings?
I have an older sister. She's 9 years older than me.
Never, you guys never got in like a...
You guys didn't have a classic avocado pit fight?
Avocado fight? Were you...
Hi, you wanna come back to the meat? Okay. Cool.